Hello friends, in this video I am going to solve exercise question from book topics in algebra. So question is, how many generators does a cyclic group of order n have? An element B of group G is a generator of G if G is equal to cyclic group generated by B. To prove this result, we need the concept of Euler phi function. So Euler phi function phi of n is the number of non-negative integers that are less than n and are relatively prime to n. So proof is, here G is a cyclic group, then G will be generated by some element, say small g in G. Now we claim that if order of G is n, that is if G consists of n number of elements, then there are phi n number of generators of group G. Here phi n is the Euler's phi function. So for G equals to cyclic group generated by element G, every element in group G will be of the form G to the power m for some integer m. Now if we consider an element, say G to the power k in G, such that this k is the divisor of n, then order of g to the power k will be strictly less than n. Reason behind this is that as k is a divisor of n, so n can be written as k1k for some k1 greater equal 0 and strictly less than k. This thing follows by division algorithm. Now order of g to the power k will be clearly k1 and k1 is strictly less than k. So from here we can conclude that for all element g to the power k in G such that k is a divisor of n, that is order of group G, then all these elements g to the power k are not generator of group G. Now consider element g to the power k in G such that GCD of k and n, that is order of group G, is 1, and let order of the element g to the power k is t for some natural number t. Now as this g to the power k is element of group G, therefore t will divide n, since order of g to the power k is t and order of group G is n. We call this expression as 1. Now as GCD of k and n is 1, there will exist integers, say n1 and n2, such that n1k plus n2n is equal to 1. This thing follows from concepts from number theory. Now g to the power k, its power t will be identity, since order of g to the power k is t. Now as this is identity, if we raise power of this term by n1, then it will still remain an identity. Now this can be written as g to the power t k n1. Now this k n1 from here can be written as 1 minus n2 n. So we will replace this k n1 by 1 minus n2 n. Then again this can be written as g to the power t g to the power minus n n2 t. Again this can be written as g to the power t g to the power minus n2 t its power n. Now as n is order of group G and g to the power minus n2 t is an element of group G, so this will be identity. Thus we get g to the power t is equal to identity. And therefore as G is generator of group G, therefore order of G will be n, and here t is an integer for which g to the power t is identity, so we must have n will be a divisor of t. We call this expression as 2. Then from 1 and 2 we have t is equal to n. Thus we can conclude that for all element g to the power k in G such that GCD of k and n is 1, we have order of g to the power k is equal to n. That is, for all such elements g to the power k in group G with GCD of k and n equals to 1, all these elements are generators of group G. And therefore, there are exactly phi n number of generators of a cyclic group of order n from definition of Euler phi function, and disproves our result.